It was late winter in Washington, D.C. A severe storm delayed all flights for the last several hours, but one flight was finally heading toward the runway and preparing to take off. As he received clearance to take off, the pilot revved up the engines and then released the brakes. The plane started its normal acceleration, but as the pilot pulled back on the yoke, the nose of the plane started to raise sluggishly. A little more power, a little more speed, and everything would be all right. But the plane wasn't lifting off the runway. All of a sudden, it was too late. There wasn't enough runway left to abort the takeoff, as the plane was going too fast, and the pilot knew exactly what was wrong. Ice on the wings. Moments later, the plane plunged into the icy waters of the Potomac River. As the plane crashed, the fuselage broke in half and began to fill with water. The shock of the crash combined with the shock of the cold water prevented most of the passengers from unbuckling their seat belts. However, there were a few who were able to get out of their seats. For them, the real struggle was just beginning. Could they live long enough in the icy waters until help could come? Almost immediately, paramedics, firemen, and policemen were dispatched to the scene, and within moments, a rescue helicopter hovered over the river where the plane had gone down. There, holding on to some floating wreckage, were several survivors. The helicopter had a rescue harness attached to the cable that it could lower. However, the harness could only pick up one person at a time. As the helicopter lowered the harness, a man grabbed it and handed it to the person next to him. He helped the person into the harness, then the helicopter lifted that person out of the icy water and over to the shore where the paramedics waited to rush that person to the hospital. The helicopter returned again and lowered the harness. Again, the same man grabbed it and gave it to the person next to him. One more person was saved from an icy grave. This happened several times, and each time the same man grabbed the harness and gave it to the neighbor, saving the neighbor's life. Finally, the helicopter returned to pick up the last man, the one who had previously grabbed the harness each time and passed it on to someone else. But as the helicopter returned and shined the spotlight on the floating debris in the river, the man was no longer there. The spotlight quickly swept up and down the river, then it swept along the banks of the river, but nothing. The man who had so unselfishly helped others was nowhere to be found. He had given the ultimate sacrifice. There were only a few bodies pulled out of that river that were not in their seat belts. That man, whoever he was, must have been one of them. Good night, Scouts.